time to make some coffee. Let's see. Do I want decaf or regular? Let's be adventurous. Regular. Together now, you'll have some time to make your own.
Oh, God, what is that?
That's called light, Garrett. Maybe you shouldn't have gone out last night.
Yeah, maybe. But it was fun. Perhaps you should have come out, Mikey.
Yeah, no, thank you. I'm not really one for social interactions.
That's a shame. You know, that girl was looking for you. Oh, what's her name? Rachel? No. Renee? Rosary?
Rebecca! Her name is Rebecca.
Oh, yeah. Anyways, Becca was hoping.
Rebecca. Rebecca. God.
That you'd come out, but sadly, I had to break the news that you'd stayed in.
What a shame.
Oh, don't give me that. No, you're into her, man. See the way you get all quiet when she shows up? Then again, you get quiet in any social situation. Or during Game of Thrones.
Hey, look, it doesn't really matter, all right? I only see her as a friend and a colleague.
Really?
Can you put on a tie or something? Forget that.
Fine.
And hurry up, too. God. You gonna just leave it like that? Really? And get your stuff together quickly. If we're not there in time, you'll definitely be fired.
Oh, I doubt that.
And then they'll fire me, too, for working with you. If we're not there for the man upstairs, we'll be done for.
Oh, calm down. He's not even gonna care.
I will not calm down. You have no responsibility for your job. Our job.
Oh, listen to me. It is going to be fine.
Grab your stuff.
Got it.
Hey, you don't want to forget this, bud.
Jesus.
What?
We should invest in a trampoline.
We live in an apartment. Oh, God. Garrett!
I'm telling you, man, not really giving it a chance.
No, I'm not. I was a Cosby Show kid. I'm sorry.
Cosby Show?
Yeah, come on. Bill Cosby? With the pudding pops and all that? Come on.
I am just saying that a reunion episode of Family Matters would be so cool.
Whatever, fine. I don't get it.
Oh, see, I told you, he's not even here yet.
Late as always.
Now, I wish I could talk to him, you know? Like, if he wants to write a book, he should actually sit down and write a book.
Well, don't drill him for it. I'm sure that it's difficult. We're just here to help.
Help?
In a way, we... You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know. Hey, from one procrastinator to another, you're not really giving us a good name. You know that? Oh, all right, suit yourself.
Stop, quit it!
All right. Time to get this started.
There we go.
Oh, finally.
Okay, let's get this done.
What's that, the 100th time he said that?
Yeah, more like 107th. Hey, now that he's finally here, we should really help him get this done. You're not yourself, remember? You're whoever he wants you to be, just not you.
I know. It's not my first day in the job.
Fine.
Wait, what's so bad about me being me?
Well, A, it's your job not to be you, and B, you're just...
No, I read you loud and clear. My natural aura of awesomeness can't be translated onto paper.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So, how does one start this book? Setting. Suburban household? More importantly, we need a plot here. Suburbia? How about a highly strict father who works in the city? An endear dropout hood rat of a son who always gets tangled in the wrong crowds. And the story opens up during a huge fight that they are having about coming home really late. The father, getting home from work, finds his son sitting around and doing nothing, and finally flips out on him for everything that he's been doing wrong.
Really? Really? I'm the hood rat son? Really?
What are you gonna do?
And as the father puts down his briefcase, he says,
God damn it, I've said over and over again, I don't care what you're doing, just come home by 12:30.
And I've told you over and over, it doesn't matter what I'm doing, and it doesn't matter when I'm home.
Under my roof, the roof that I put over your head, those things do matter. I'm not gonna have some kid who runs around and does drugs, breaks the law, and comes home whenever to act like he owns the place. I keep you in this house, and I can kick you out.
See, you always say that, but oh look, I'm still here. It doesn't matter what you say, you're not gonna kick me out.
Oh yes, I will. I've had it up to here with everything you do, and I'm completely sick of it.
Fine, do it. See if I care. I got friends I can stay with. I don't need this place. I can just go
Nah. This isn't going to work. This isn't going to go anywhere. 2/10 of a starting point. It won't go anywhere.
Yeah, not one of his best ideas.
Yeah, agreed.
I need something more interesting.
You know, son, I'd really appreciate
it. Stop it.
How about everyday life in Chicago? The sun rises over a snow-covered city, and there is a small house among the suburbs. A plain-looking man gets ready for another monotonous, boring, and uneventful day at work.
Oh, wow, that sounds just like you. You're gonna do great.
Another man appears out of another room in the house. The man walking in is a construction contractor working in the basement.
Well, like I said before, probably gonna need a couple cross beams along the ceiling downstairs.
Why so? When I bought this place, the realtor said that everything was in tip-top shape.
Yeah, well, they say that, but well, these old houses were meant to accommodate the modern appliances on the ground floor.
So what you're saying is I'm gonna need more structural support in the basement.
Yeah, I'd say that in the least.
All right. Well, I know I'm gonna be out of town for the next week, so maybe if your crew would like to come in.
No. This is boring. No one will want to read this ever. Damn it, Ben. You need to get yourself together, man. You've been living off ramen and Kool-Aid for 3 months now. You need to write something that'll get yourself out of this minimum wage living. You're never going to make it anywhere like this. Dad was right. I should have just become a mechanic like him or something. Whatever. What is something that interests people? What is popular today? I'll Google it.
Oh, he's Googling something.
So, that means he'll probably be led to YouTube, which means he will probably spend a nearly criminal amount of time watching videos.
So, break?
Break.
All right, All right.
Wait, what? That was a pretty short Googling session. He must have actually stayed focused.
Yeah, funny joke.
So we open in a far-off medieval land.
All right, let's just get started.
A noble knight is exploring the vast wilderness.
Oh, like Game of Thrones! Am I gonna be an evil knight or a sorcerer or something?
The knight traverses a rocky valley to come across a makeshift house and finds a fair maiden tending to crops outside.
No.
The knight walks to the woman and grabs her attention.
Nope. No.
Hello, my mistress of peasantry. Hello, my mistress of peasantry. Hello!
Hey, dude.
What? What happened to, we're here to help him, and don't be yourself?
I'm drawing the line here. This is not happening.
But then what is he gonna write?
What the hell? I thought that was going good. I'm getting a complete mental blank. And I felt like it was going somewhere, too. You know what? This won't stop me. I'll just keep rolling. The knight stumbles upon a war-hardened ranger seeking vengeance for his brother's death.
All right! Now this is something I can roll with.
The ranger approaches the knight quickly, and with anger in his voice, he begins to say,
You and your clan hath killed my brother, mine own flesh and blood.
I tell you, my good sir, my clan that you refer to is that which keeps order in the kingdom.
Don't you try me for a fool. That order of which you speak is no more than a tyrannical law and rule by those above you. Alas, ignorance seems to be your strongest trait.
I am beyond aware of the motives of His Majesty and His High Council. Peace and order must be sustained throughout the land if there must be peace. There must be no time or patience for rebels like yourself.
This rebellion is more than an attack on the crown. It shall bring change to the minds of the proletariat and the peasantry. It shall spark hope in the eyes of the children to rise up and strike down their oppressors.
You, your brother, and all that fell aside from him were nothing more than pawns in a feeble attempt to overthrow the king.
Well, I may not kill the king, but I shall achieve the same satisfaction in cutting you down.
Then you shall join your brother amongst the dead.
Oh, you. Have at you. I have long awaited this day.
You fight well, Ranger.
You certainly better.
Trickster.
I don't get it. Why'd he stop? What's the problem? He was making progress. We were making progress.
I don't know.
Me.
Oh no.
Oh god. Whoa, dude.
He is sleeping. Sleeping! And we've been sitting around here doing jack shit.
Calm down, he'll wake up.
I'm not talking about just now. I'm talking about all the time. We've been coming to this job for over a year now, and what have we done? Stupid, frivolous activities that he writes down.
But like you said, we're...
Hey, asshole! You can't keep doing this, all right? You can't keep having us sitting around, doing whatever you want forever, and expect us to keep our sanity. And helping, my friend, helping implies that something better is happening. We are not helping anyone. But we have made zero progress with him towards anything. He couldn't stick with a single damn idea if his life depended on it. I'm leaving.
Leaving? You can't leave until it's done.
Oh, like you've ever cared about this job.
Well, showing up late is one thing, but leaving, you'll get fired.
I don't care, because I quit. I don't mind how you can get up every morning and do the same thing over and over again and be perfectly fine with it. I know I'm not. Do you hear me, you miserable excuse for a writer?
Oh my.
Where do you think this will bring you? Where do you think all these failed ideas and trash books will get you? Nowhere. You're not going anywhere. You're waking up in the morning and repeating the same process daily. Your routine stays the same, yet you somehow expect your life to take off. How can anyone live like that? You've got a boring, dead-end job that you don't even enjoy, and a small, sad apartment. You've got absolutely no social life, and you don't even have enough guts to ask out a girl who is clearly into you. Oh, no. Oh, God, Garrett, what if you're right? What if I am just a boring guy with a completely uneventful life?
Oh, no. I didn't mean it like that. I was just joking.
But what if, look at it. I have no life beyond work and home. If you eliminate those things, I'm literally nothing. I barely have any friends.
Well, you got me.
Oh, God.
And you've got way more than that. You're hands down the smartest guy I know, and you're neat and organized. Hell, if it weren't for you, the apartment would be more of a disaster than Ben Affleck as Batman. See, there you go. And you've got friends, you just don't see them at all.
Huh?
Yeah, whenever I go out, they always ask, where's Mikey, or why didn't Mikey come out?
Really?
Yes, really. So, personally, I'd advise that you come out with me next time.
All right. I'll think about it. Thank you. Hey, it's Rebecca. But how did she get my number?
I don't know. It was me.
She wants me to come out and get dinner with her tonight.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I'll have enough time, too.
Well?
I'm getting her at 8. I'm picking her up at 8. Oh, God, what should I wear?
Oh, how about some clothes?
Really? Is this all right?
Yes. You look fine, don't worry.
What do I say to her? Like, how do I talk to her? Oh, no. Do I have to pay for her?
Yes, you have to pay for her. You're a guy. That's your job. And make small talk. You know, get to know her and the normal stuff.
Jeez, I don't know where it came from. Just all of a sudden, the ideas started flowing. And before I even knew it, I just wrote myself a book. What do you think of me now, Dad? Oh, I need to find a publisher. Wait a minute. I don't have an ending.
Come on.
I got it. Michael and Garrett soon went home and prepared for Mike's date. Michael and Rebecca hit it off and are now going steady, and Garrett has started making efforts to clean up after himself. They continued to live and work together and received some well-deserved promotions. It seems that the endless hallway that Michael saw his life as had a room at the end that led to an open room of infinite possibilities. Oh, and yes, they did invest in that trampoline. The end.